What's going on, dudes? It is Kolosalus here. Welcome back to some more Heroes of the Storm. Today, we are taking yet another look at Falstad. Today, we'll be taking a look at this auto-attack build, so hopefully we're not gonna get stunned, we're not gonna get blinded, and we're gonna do some work. So let's go!
Let's fly!
Alright, boys and girls, you find yourselves on the Garden of Terror map. Level 1, we're gonna go for Seasoned Marksman, basically for every single... Right, what's actually... Because the tooltip actually changed over the last patch. Let's say hi to the friends first. And actually, Tass, I will be going basic attack build. So shield me when you can. Yes, so we just informed our friendly support, Tassadar, who will be probably will be going for Leeching Plasma and Callous Embrace to shield me whenever he can, just so I can get some more healing. Anyway, what's a new tooltip for Seasoned Marksman? Every minion killed near you grants you 0.2 attack damage and takedowns grant you 0.5 attack damage to a max of 40 damage. Upon gaining 40, you basically gain your 1, which is your active, which gives you 30% of your attack speed, 30% additional attack speed for 3 seconds. So, you know, basically the caps have been capped. Oh, I'm dead. So, what was my mistake there? Because the enemy... Enemy Kerrigan did not use her combo there, and I got taken out anyway. And I'm gonna throw it back in there. We're gonna use our Z ability, which is called Flight, and on a 45-second cooldown allows us to fly in a very large radius. So we have missed about 7 stacks. So right now I'll be a little bit more careful of who is ganking. Looks like we are missing 2 people, so I'm just gonna be careful of who's coming from the bottom. But again, I should stay close enough to the lane to actually get the Seasoned Marksman stacks. On our Q ability, we have, again, a skill shot which will travel forward and back, deal damage, you know, both ways. He's right there in the bush. So I'm going to stay in lane a little bit longer. And just to get some more stacks, you know, just to make up for the lost stacks that we had. Yeah, it's gonna deal damage, actually quite heavy damage. It's a base of his mage stat build. Anyway, we're gonna come in here, just get some of these stacks. And it's also going to slow the enemy hit for 2 seconds by 25%. Very, very, very good. Very, very good. Yeah, we're good. On a double ability, we have Lightning Rod. Deal 120 damage to the enemy, and then additional 84 every second for 4 seconds. On my way to the bottom lane, I'm just gonna fly right there to get there faster. Maybe I should have just went with the lane there. Anyway, we're just gonna start hammering away at this motherfucker. We're waiting for our level 4 talent. There's a skill on the enemy Murky, very nice stun from the friendly Murden. He is in trouble now, but he will be fine. And then our E ability is called a barrel roll. We're able to dodge and to basically dodge or just dash in a certain direction. We gotta be careful of the enemy combo. Looks like she cannot land one for shit, which is good. I mean, I'm never mad that she can't land a combo, right? So here comes a lightning strike coming out on the enemy Kerrigan. That's going to be a kill right on her. That was a very good stun by our friendly Murden. On my way, flying top, because there's nobody soaking this. On this range, we're going to go for hammer gains. Basically, a percentage to... this is basically a very specific version to Falstad. The normal Vampiric Assault, or what is it actually called now? Like Vigorous Assault or something like that? I don't know. So the normal one will give you... 15% basically damage dealt back with your basic attacks back as health. This is gonna give you 20. So they basically try to compensate the removal of first aid in the latest patch by giving him a little bit more sustain with his basic attacks. Not gonna be a huge deal, but definitely is gonna help out sustain some heroes. Yeah, man. So that's exactly what I was waiting for, our level 4 talent, which should allow us to just out-sustain a little bit of that. So I'm like this Liming, so I can just come in here and auto-attack her to... No, it's just, I can just auto-attack her, and I should be able to out-sustain it. I should be definitely careful of the globe, because it can deal shit ton of damage to me. I used to be able to out-sustain her almost at all times, you know, with the first aid and vigorous assault or whatever it was, but now... Nice stun, and there's a kill. Good job. Good gank by the friendly team. Holy shit. On this damage, we're gonna go for secret weapon, increasing the range of our Q. And why, you know, you might want to think, why are we increasing the range of our Q? Well, we're doing that because it also gives us additional crit damage when with our basic attacks when our hammerang is out. Therefore, we will be doing more damage when I throw my Q. So let's see. So I throw my Q and I start our attack, and you can see I'm dealing much more damage than I normally do. So it's almost 100 more damage. Crazy amounts of damage, boys. Crazy amounts of damage. I did not dodge that in time, but we're all good, we're all good. This just gives me a little bit more damage output against this this Li Meng if she decides to. Because she went, I think, for the damage on her teleport, which is going to make her... Oh, that was good. That was a good hit. I didn't expect that, though. Yeah, Li Meng. Yeah, Li Meng. Yeah, Li Meng. Oh shit, no! Okay, I'm good, I'm good, I'm good. So we are getting some crazy, crazy stacks up in here. I need to be careful of anybody coming from the bottom. I'm gonna grab the sippy real quick. Looks like the objective is gonna start up again in about 20 seconds. She's not gonna get hit by that. I hope so, just so she could be slowed. I'm being greedy with this. Anyway, I will be able to heal off my basic attacks, and I was you know, I stayed in lane long enough to gather up some of the stacks. I'm gonna try to be careful here in the top lane, try to gather these motherfuckers up, and we'll be good. I really do believe the auto attack build is not, you know, is not like 100% dead. You know, everybody said zero stress Falstad is dead, you know, and I do believe that zero stress Falstad is dead. It's just, you know, his auto-attack build is not dead. Leoric is up behind us. What we're gonna do is just we're gonna be dealing some damage to the enemy team. Just basically, again, throwing out my Q and just auto-attacking, just focusing on auto-attack and doing as much auto-attack as we possibly can. On this level range, I feel like when you have enough damage, therefore I'm just gonna go for Mighty Gust. Mighty Gust will allow us to disengage and also push back the enemies into us. So for example, I can fly up behind them. And, you know, do some crazy plays with that. Yeah, so there's Leeching Plasma. Leoric is behind us, like, fucking... I'm just gonna fly out of that, Tim Tim. There's a nice stun, and you can see I'm just gonna start hammering away at Leoric there. The enemy team actually uses the Terror here as a mean of... attacking. I will be taken out by the damage. I was just caught out a little bit out of position. I shouldn't have flew over here. I should have just made my round over there because they were following me around here. I should have just went over the wall and just went that way. That would have been a much more, I think, safer play. I just didn't think about it in the time. Yeah, I really didn't expect the enemy team. That was really bad. I think he's dead. Actually, I was a really bad gust. I should have just let them be in here. I should have just let them, you know, just basically totally just stay there. They were really in a bad spot. I'm just gonna get polymorphed. So it's Murky. I wouldn't even worry about Murky. I wouldn't even worry about killing him. Anyway, I'm gonna come in here on the enemy Leoric. He will be pushed out of the lane pretty easily by us. Friendly Chromie is taking care of the business in the bottom lane. Alright, that was a fail. He's hit me with the slow. Alright, on my way to deal some damage to this objective. Anyway, we're gonna experience our spike, spike of damage on level 20, and we will get next friend's basically increased attack speed. So we will be able to. Need to be careful here. Very nice haymaker actually. She's body blocking me. There's a kill on the enemy. What's the name? Enemy Leoric right there. Very, very nice. And we kept them out of the team fight, basically winning it before. So I'm gonna try to soak some damage for this Chromie. We're unsuccessful in doing so. I'm actually just gonna go fly top to get some of those stacks. Get some more stacks, you know. I'm gonna go giant killer on this level range just because it further improves my damage of my basic attacks. Against basically against heroes with higher health total. But again, like if I attack, even the less tanky hero. I'll be able to disengage with my Mighty Gust, go back to the Sippy. Oh, he's dead. He's dead as fuck, right? Yeah, man. Oh god, that fucking heals so good. Oh, look at the damage right there. Like, it was me and Chromie, but again, we did shit ton of damage right there. Anyway, my Zed is off cooldown again. I need to be careful of this Kerrigan jumping onto us. She doesn't know how to land her combo, which is quite lucky for us. Anyway, we will be getting a lot of damage, because we picked up Giant Killer, which basically scales up with... Yeah, oh man, there you go. So basically what Giant Killer will give us additional damage upon the percentage of health that the enemy I'm attacking has. So for example, let's say I'm attacking a tank, I'll be doing so much damage. I'll be doing so much more damage, you know what I mean? Anyway, this Viorik is in here, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna do this. Just all the damage that I have in here will be just raped basically here. And here we should just focus on this objective. Yeah, I was doing the wrong thing. The enemy Rhaegar coming in. Whoa, the blow up from the friendly team. Nova doing so much work. Good. I'm glad we actually have a team who can do this shit. Anyway, we're gonna pick those up. Gonna go back for mana. This build is not as mana hungry as the other two, but it's gonna still require some from you. One really good thing about Falstad is just I can fly straight back into the fight. Our team has been abandoned here, therefore I'm just gonna fly into this bush right here. And if they decide to follow, which they did, actually Merc just walked into it, but. Yeah, nice and tomb, bro. Nice and tomb. So I had two ways of disengaging there. I had, I had my bear roll and my mighty gust if I did have to use it. Anyway, I will be able to out-sustain against them. Nope, sorry. It's actually very good that she can't land the combo. Alright, there's a slow on the enemy Leoric. I'm just gonna stand here and rain punishment with my giant killer and stuff on him. Not a big deal. On the same range, we are gonna go for 80 gust, decreasing the amount of time we have to wait for our trade, which I actually didn't explain to you guys, so it's all my fault. increasing the amount of the movement speed bonus that we actually get. Honestly, I should just focus this guy, and I will be doing that. He has been on my Nova, and what I'm trying to do right here, very nice stun from the friendly, Muradin I'm just gonna push them away so they don't do too much damage to our friendly Chromie. She will be fine, I think. And honestly, we can just come back here, or come right back. There's some damage on the enemy Li Ming, she'll be able to blink out of there. Now, wow, very nice flank by the enemy Kerrigan, but she will be just bursted right the fuck down. She's just told to sit the fuck down. Very nice stun from the friendly, Muradin is gonna secure a kill on the enemy Rhaegar. like, it's not our job to help you. It is. It isn't. Again, just you can see how much damage we're able to do with with the help of the giant killer right there and all of our abilities to the to the enemy tank. Basically, I'm just gonna read you to the tutorial because I can't really explain it. Let's try to explain it. So let's we have our base damage which is improved by the seasoned marksman, right? An additional damage is added to every single auto attack based on the max health of the enemy I'm attacking. So I'm not sure what the actual percentage is added. 1.5%. So it's not huge, but it's definitely going to scale up when it comes to killing tanks and killing more tanky targets. But again, it's gonna just add that tad more damage that we need in killing mages too. It's not bad for that either. We're gonna come in here, try to help our friendly team. We are doing actually quite a heavy damage right now with our basic attacks, to be honest with you. The enemy team is caught out of position. Gonna fly behind this Kerrigan. Wow. Ah! Anyway, I'm gonna try to hammer right here on the enemy Li Ming. I did miss the gust. I tried to put that Li Ming out of position, put her into our friendly team. And honestly, she should be dead. Yeah, man. There you go. Good job. Very good. Triple tap is gonna secure a kill. Hi, Leoric. Hey, yeah, friend. Yeah, we can unsustain you. I'll damage you all day, every day. What was slowing my my basic attacks? I'm not sure. Does he slow my basic attacks with the swing as well? I don't think so. So I don't know what the fuck that was. Yeah, we should definitely do this. Look how much we're able to heal with Leeching Plasma. Almost 119 every single basic attack. Holy damn. There you go. You can see. Just crazy. Crazy good. Tassadar is actually a very good support in today's meta. Yeah, so our trait, actually, I still didn't explain it. I'm just bad at it. I'm actually gonna fly top to defend against this push. Hi, Murky! That was good, Murky. That was good. I'm glad. I'm really proud of you. I'm really proud of you. There you go. There's a kill on Demi Murky. Not gonna be a huge deal, but it's gonna allow us to take him out of this lane, basically stopping this push. It's called Tailwind. Basically, after the base version is after not taking damage for 6 seconds, you will be moving 20% faster up until you take damage again. We did pick up Eerie Gust, which what it does basically is we actually got our Season Marksman stacks now. I'm gonna go bottom here. Looks like the enemy team is in the middle, so I'm gonna try to just sneak in some kills there. on the summary, we're gonna go for Nexus Frenzy, increasing our attack speed and the range of our basic attacks by so much. I'm not actually sure of the number. Let's see. It is a 20% attack speed increase and 20% range increase, which is gonna allow us to just hit enemies who are a little bit farther away from us. The friendly team is doing a great job at taking away the attention of the enemy, and also actually killing the enemy team. They will not be able to respond to me as quickly as they would be able to if they would be alive, right? That's just a logical thing to actually do. The enemy team is going to use their terror to defend instead do anything. Yeah, come in. I'm just going to destroy this tower, and honestly, I'm fucking out of here. We should be definitely careful. We should be defending. The friendly team should be defending, and I will be doing all the pushing that we need. Friendly Nova was a little bit of a pickle, but she will be fine. I'm going to come in here. I do have another guy ready, so I'm just going to put it right in the middle. Destroy the Murky Egg. The Murky Egg is dead. So if we do get a pick on him right now, for the Nova, like, she has a lot of potential. And what I can do is I can do this. Hi. I'm just going to try to get this fort before we expire. We got 13 seconds. And we will be able to get this, to get another fort right here. Honestly, we should be careful because we already have 4 seconds. I'm going to put this behind us. So they walk into it. And honestly, we can do some damage afterwards. The enemy Kerrigan is not a huge threat as she cannot...
You guys saw me use the mighty gust. I wanted to push Kerrigan away so I didn't fucking die. It didn't come out for some reason. Sometimes just weird shit happens. Like, I know I was displaced, but I pressed it before I was displaced. So, you know, it should have worked before I was displaced. Anyway, looks like the enemy team still picks up friendly team still picks up a kill on the enemy Rhaegar, which is good. Very nice stun. It's not gonna secure a kill, but definitely it's gonna make him scared for his life. Close the Auric, not even close enough. That's a nice push we have going on right here. That was just my fault, I'm guessing displacement actually does interrupt my cast of my Aegis, so I don't know. This is a very bad. This is very bad. Our Tassadar's dead. That plays. They're not dead. Wow. Just disengage. Oh my god, he's dead. He's gonna heal. What? I was dead. The friendly team is just dying for no apparent reason, you know, I mean, there's nobody there, like, I'm not there, it is just like fucking... It's just a bloodbath right now, because the friendly team is just dying for no apparent reason. I'm just trying to deal with this push, because it's quite a lengthy push. You can see how much quicker we are attacking right here, because of the Nexus Frenzy. The friendly team is having a little bit of trouble right here, you know, dealing with the enemy team. The enemy team is gonna get a lot of seats from this, because the friendly team did engage without me. I have not used my Seasoned Marksman even once yet, which is kind of weird. There you go, very nice. I've actually saved her right there, so I hope she's fucking happy now. The enemy Kerrigan has a tendency of just diving deep, therefore, like, if she dives deep right there, like, right there, we have a chance of bursting her right down. Okay, there's the blink coming out, but we will pick up a kill on the Yorick instead, though. The enemy team is pushing a little bit top. Didn't get a hit right there. We should just hit this for days. I will be actually dealing quite massive damage. God damn, that was close. And we should be careful because the enemy terror is coming in, therefore I think this is going to be a little bit of tough for the friendly team to do. Stasis is going to actually save the enemy terror from imminent damage. I'm going to come in here, just increase my damage right here. Oh shit, I just blinked right, I rolled right into the... This is way too long. I'm good. Are we good? Yeah, hey, we're good. I had nothing. I honestly had nothing. Honestly, I do mute people like this, but I just don't want to get salty. Like, this guy's dead, right? What the fuck?! I'm gonna get him! Yeah! I got him for no apparent reason. I was stressing him for days. Now I'm backing up to my core because the enemy team is pushing that. I don't think I'll be able to do too much. I've got my handy dandy. Pushed him away from the core, and honestly, he's dead. He's dead. Why is my auto attack just fucking done? Oh, he went for imposing presence. That's why. Why is my attack slow when I'm attacking Leoric? That's why, because he went imposing presence. Let's just check that quickly.
And he did go imposing presence. That's why we were attacking very, very sluggishly. Looks like he's just going to be standing under the core. Therefore, I'm just going to stand here and actually kill him whenever he spawns. It looks like he is going to be backing up right now. I do want to follow him a little bit. The orc is still right here. Yeah, just spawn faster. Just spawn faster so I can fucking kill you again. That's fine. Alright, she's dead. Good job. By the friendly team right here, we should be actually contesting this because it looks like the enemy team is on this, actually was on this, so I think they just backed the fuck away. And let's say we're gonna try to hammer away at this guy. You can see how much, almost 500 per ranged attack when our secret weapon is out, where we have the effect of our secret weapon. Nuts damage, I gotta tell you guys. Actually, the damage is very, very good. The enemy Leoric is scouting our positions, therefore we should definitely be careful. Hi there! Okay, this fort is still not down. Yeah! Okay, we're fine. Holy shit, look at the damage. Oh shit, okay. Give me a sippy, I am stunned. And there's a shield. I pressed my E and I was mid-barrel roll. Somehow still got taken out. I can't complain. We did quite a lot of work with our life right here. We did kill a murky, but we lost... Triple tap is gonna... because she'd be interrupted and she's gonna be taken out. But they do pay a Kerrigan life for that. Our Tastar is gonna go into Prescience? What did he go for? Just standard build. Standard race guard build. Oh my god, the damage right there is actually pretty huge. Oh god! Oh, Nelly. Oh, Nelly, she's just raining punishment on them. Honestly, I don't know what the fuck that was, but okay. She's just gonna leech off of them. I've got 19 seconds, which means I won't be able to help her at all. If she can pick up the skill, though. Oh, baby! Okay, there's a kill. I think I'm gonna fly mid straight away to defend against this push. We have this right there. Honestly, yeah, I want to get this pushing out as soon as we possibly can. Looks like they're just trying to paint the map red right here. Therefore, we should be careful of this. They might be doing that straight away. Yeah, the Murky is on that, so definitely should be careful. And a very nice kill on Murky is gonna maybe secure, maybe another kill here. Honestly, man. Hi. You get a stun? I'm gonna activate my Seasoned Marksman right here. Alright, there's a kill. I'm not getting a lot of healing right here. Honestly, I'm just trying to do the stuff that I can. Very nice. Yeah, buddy. Oh, that was bad. That was a bad haymaker. That was a bad haymaker, bro. Yeah, okay. Thank you for the shield. Honestly, the shields are what making us pretty good. On my way to help this Chromie because she's gonna be complaining again. Honestly, we should be getting mana afterwards. Should get some seeds. We only need 20. Hi, Murky. I'm just gonna take some of these off of you. Thank you. And I don't wanna have anything to do. Anything else to do with you? The enemy team might be rotating top. Oh, the orc's behind us. He was behind us at least. So we have to be careful. I'm not gonna use my disengage right here. I'm gonna come in here and burst down this enemy Kerrigan, and I'm gonna try to come in here, activate my seasoned marksman, and I'll be just able to rain punishment on this enemy Leoric. You can see how much damage we're able to do, and really out-sustain him as well. Coming here on this enemy Rhaegar. Again, when I attack him, you know, my attack speed is just horrendous. Therefore, we won't be able to do too much. Can it actually fly right here? Okay, that's fine. Very nice stun is gonna secure a kill on the enemy Leoric, though. Very nice Stormbolts coming out from the friendly Muradin. Looks like he's still you know, even after the nerfs, he still proves to be very, very what the fuck? We can push, yeah, we can definitely shove the shit out of this. There's the murky egg, and honestly, we can just shove the hell out of this fort. I don't see why not. And honestly, if she I know she wants to engage. They're definitely baiting us right now. So I'm trying to not split away from the friendly. Wow, that was bad. That was a bad haymaker, bro. I'm just focusing him down. We can see how much damage I'm able to do. Very nice stun from the enemy Kerrigan is gonna actually not secure a kill, but it's gonna definitely secure the living. Oh my god, you can see how much damage from the basic attacks we're able to do now. Honestly, this could be game. This could potentially be game. Let's just focus core. Dude, this game. The game of throws from the enemy team. Honestly, I don't give a shit. Okay, I'm gonna get stunned and probably I'm gonna get raped by here. We are losing friendlies right now. By the way, this glitch is still happening. She still has the triple tap attached to her. Oh my god, really bad, very bad, what's the name? A very bad snipe is not gonna hit the enemy Li Ming, and we will be almost all wiped out. This Muradin is trying to make... Alright, does he have mana for... Yeah, there you go, there's a leap, and mount up! Oh, that was his only chance to mount up right there. I don't think he'll be taken out. She definitely not recall. He's dead. I think the enemy Murky has the stun. Okay, it looks like he doesn't have the stun. Haymaker is gonna put Leoric out of position. Okay, he's gonna mount up. There we go. Okay, so he's gonna be able to get out of there. Li Ming is attacking our core by herself. And she honestly might be able to do this if the friendly Muradin doesn't come in and do something. But yeah, the enemy team is just gonna finish the game right here. That was our chance. If all of us would have focused on the core, we would have been fine. We would have won the game right there. Honestly, I still call it a good game. Our Chromie did call everybody out. I mean, she thought she was the shit. Where, in all honesty, she wasn't. She was good. I mean, she don't get me wrong. She was okay, but she just wasn't the shit. If you know what I mean. We did. Oh my god! Holy shit! I'm just trying to kind of let these numbers sink in. This is a basic attack build. And it has CC. And it had burst damage. And I died 5 times, so that was pretty bad. But other than that, holy damn it! This is this another build which looks super, super viable for Falstad. And again, with Tassadar being able to give us so much healing from us from the shields as well, with Seasoned Marksman and you know all the other upgrades like you know the Secret Weapon and Giant Killer, we were able to heal for so much. How much healing did you get? He got 102,000 healing off of me, basically, because I was only the basic attack hero on this team. Of course, Nova can do some basic attacks and shit like that, but other than that, look at the healing he's done. He's done more than Rhaegar. That is some crazy stats, bro. Crazy stats. Anyway, I'm gonna go over the build again. A build I came up with myself. I mean, you know, you only go for the basic attack talents, honestly. Like, just to be honest with you guys. There are some other choices, but I just don't think they're good enough. Seasoned Marksman to get some more damage on your basic attacks, basically. When you stack it up to 40, the 40 bonus damage, you will be granted an one active, which you can activate to increase your attack speed by 30% for 3 seconds. On level 4, we went for Hammer Gains, giving us something like a buffed up Vigorous Assault, giving us 20% of the damage dealt back as healing. Level 7 went for secret weapon, increasing the hammerang range and basic attack damage by 60%. The range is increased by 30 and the damage is increased by 60%. Very, very good. On level 10 went for mighty glass just because I was thinking we would get some value from flying behind and trying to push them into our friendly team. Didn't work out, we mainly used it as a disengage, but it was still pretty damn good. On level 13 went for giant killer, basic, empowers your basic attacks against heroes, you know, basic bonus damage equal to 1.5% of the hero's maximum health. This might be huge for like someone like a Leoric, but no, it might not be that huge against a Murky, you know what I mean? On level 16 we did go for the 80 gust, which just gives us a little bit more mobility around the map. That's actually what I was striving for right there. Kind of getting us closer to the actual movement speed of the mount. And also only waiting 2 seconds like, instead of 6 is just super good. And level 20 we did go for the next frenzy, just kind of really building around the basic attack build. You know, we already have disengage, we already have very good mobility around the map, especially with the area gas too, and therefore I just need some more range to attack the enemy heroes and some more attack speed to just kind of complement, you know, our level 4 pick and level 7 pick even further. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. This is going to be the last Falstad video I'm going to make before I'm going to have a break. I am going to have a break. It's very unfortunate, but I'm going to have a break from recording. Not sure for how long. Might be a while, might not be a while. But I will try to record a few more videos. I still have. So I've finished all the Falstad videos. I have got 2 Arthas to go and 1 Anubarak. So that's what I want to get done before I leave. Thank you guys for watching again. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, slap that like rating if you haven't already subscribed to the channel. And as always, I'll see you guys next time. Peace on the motherfucking streets.